A Catalunya, cada any ens visiten 18 milions de persones, turistes d'arreu del món que venen atrets per les meravelles del nostre país. I lluny de ser una massa homogènia, són persones amb noms i cognoms que amaguen històries sorprenents. I jo vull descobrir-les totes.
És per això que els tornaré a la visita.
Benvinguts a Cases d'Algú. Per això, he instal·lat un plató mòbil a diferents llocs de Catalunya. I he demanat a la gent que hi havia que entrés a la caravana a xerrar amb mi. A tots els hi he fet les mateixes tres preguntes. Com et dius?
Welcome.
D'on ets?
Welcome.
I per què hauria de visitar el teu país?
Hello. Okay.
My name is Stu.
My name is Jasmine.
And I'm Steve.
Andrea Fisher, but my friends call me Fluter Scooter.
Why?
Because I play the flute and ride a scooter at the same time.
Really?
No.
Okay.
Fatima.
My name is Wolf Eric.
I used to have a scooter and I always had my flute.
Quin personatge aquesta flautista?
That's how it's a nickname.
Are you a professional flutist?
Yes, I
am. I'm from Bergen in Norway.
Originally from Iran.
Soc de Glasgow, a Escòcia.
I veig que parles català.
Sí, sí.
Originally I'm from Philadelphia and now I'm living in Iowa City.
Iowa. Què hi ha a Iowa?
We're from Brisbane, Australia.
I vaig venir aquí per aprendre castellà, però vaig viure un any a Girona i, bueno, sí. I vaig aprendre el català.
I t'he de dir que el parles molt bé.
I'm in Barcelona because I'm visiting a few shops in Spain that sell my flute bags. I have a line of flute bags, which are fashionable handbags for flutes.
Fundes de flauta. Artista i emprenedora, mola.
Why, when I said hello, you did not shake my hand?
Me, as a woman, mm-hmm. just have a handshaking with women.
Yes.
And some of men that are really close to me.
Per què hauria de visitar la teva ciutat?
You should visit there because there are a lot of deer. And I actually moved there because I love deer. And I see deer all the time.
Ah, ara toquen cèrvols.
The bees. The beaches and the barbecues.
The barbecues?
Three bees.
I could take you sea kayaking on the very edge of the, well, the Norwegian continent.
Em convidaries a casa teva?
Sí, 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 clar.
And it's better for my country that you go to the hotel.
Okay.
Of course. Yes.
Hope to see you there.
Of course.
Yes.
Maybe we'll even see some deer.
Primera història d'avui. Arribo a Iowa City, als Estats Units, per conèixer l'Andrea, una flautista amant dels cèrvols que, a més, dissenya fundes per flautes. No sé ben bé què m'hi trobaré a Iowa, però si fins ara he estat capaç de conviure amb gats i gossos, segur que també podré conviure amb cèrvols, oi? Mira, fa solet, no deu fer gaire fred. Collons que no!
Hello!
Hola!
How are you?
Bienvenido a Iowa!
Hi!
Welcome to Iowa. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you. You are Nicole?
Nicole,
okay.
Sí.
How are you?
L'Andrea em va prometre que em presentaria la seva gran amiga, la Nicole, flautista com ella i professora a la Universitat d'Iowa.
So, let's go.
Let's go. Yes?
Yeah.
By car or...?
By car. We're going to go in my
okay.
car. Yeah.
Perfect.
Aquesta història és un 2x1 en tota regla. Una oferta així no es pot deixar escapar. To behold the
natural gates. When and how did you meet each other?
Well, about 20 years ago.
Oh.
We were doing our bachelor's degree at a university in Pittsburgh,
uh-huh.
Carnegie Mellon University. It's a very famous good university in the United States, and we were studying music there. Mm-hmm. And we met our first year. Then we got to be friends and we practiced a lot. We spent like probably 8 or 9 hours every day practicing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I've only lived in big cities. So I lived in New York, LA, and actually Tokyo. And I moved here because I was here back in March, staying with Nicole for a flute festival. And I
I wanted to be around deer because I love deer so much.
Now you are living here because Nicole, of course, but because deers too?
Mostly because of deer, yes.
Oh, yeah, mostly because deer.
Ah, molt bé. Prefereix els cèrvols a la seva amiga, que curiós.
Yeah, my house is actually just over on the other side of those trees over there, and I have deer in my backyard all the time. Oh, she has deer.
Really?
She has a nice buck. Yeah.
I want to see a deer with you.
Yeah, I would love to. We're going to try. I really hope to try.
I would love to.
Well, she loves deer, and I love foxes.
Ah, you love foxes?
Yeah.
Okay,
see, my foxes are
back here.
She can show you.
Wow! Hello!
That's Hanky and Panky.
Panky and?
Hanky.
Ara entenc per què són amigues. Quin parell.
Hanky is the boy and Panky is the girl.
Okay, so Hanky and Panky.
Panky.
Encantats de conèixer-vos. Hola.
Em sorprèn la seva manca de pudor per reconèixer coses que a ulls de molta gent la poden fer passar per una llunàtica. Però qui estigui lliure d'excentricitats, que tiri la primera pedra. En aquest cas, que tiri el primer panqui.
And why Iowa in your case? Because of university?
Or? Yeah, for me it's because of the university. We have a excellent school of music here. And I got the job here when I was just 27 years old. As a professor, which is kind of young and typically in the United States, but it's such a great job and I have amazing students and I really love teaching and love living here, even though I never thought I would live in Iowa City.
So it seems that you are a top flutist.
We are a top flutist.
You can say that we are top flutists.
Yes? Okay. Okay.
I would like
both of us travel all over the world to perform, and I do a lot of teaching, so I guess that makes us a top flutist.
Al cotxe, l'André i la Nicole em comenten que no anirem directament a casa. No es poden estar de començar aquest viatge ensenyant-me la seva gran passió, la música. O sigui que primer farem una parada a l'escola on la Nicole ensenya els seus alumnes a tocar la flauta. Iowa City és una ciutat universitària. La Universitat d'Iowa és la més important de tot l'estat. Aquí hi viuen més de 30.000 estudiants. Vaja, com si tot Cambrils hagués vingut a fer un Erasmus.
Nicole Esposito.
That's me.
That's you.
This is where the magic happens.
Hòstia. Hòstia, amb l'oficineta. Uau.
Jo, quan anava a plorar al profe perquè m'apugés la nota, no havia vist mai cap despatx com aquest. En aquest despatx és on la Nicole passa gran part del temps. Aquí prepara les classes, fa les lliçons als alumnes i assaja per les actuacions que fa arreu del món. Pel que m'expliquen, això de ser una flautista top no és gens fàcil. Jo no en seria capaç si amb prou feines vaig aprendre a tocar el plou i fa sol a l'escola.
Let's play a little bit.
Yes, we're going to visit the concert hall.
Concert hall?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, this is solid.
My God. Mare meva.
Estic flipant. Ara em faran una demostració del seu talent. Tocaran una peça de Vivaldi. I el més curiós és que l'Andrea diu que ho farà mentre toca l'orgue amb els peus.
The flute, I see the flute personally as like another limb. When I pick this up and it makes a sound, it's just a part of my body that is supposed to be there. And the sound that comes out is just an expression and
it's an extension of our voice. Like, I don't feel like there's a thing there when I play.
Oh.
Exactly.
I'm just talking.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
How important is music in your lives?
It's pretty much 100% important. I mean, music, well, for me, music is a reflection of life,
So for me, music is completely my life because I think anything you do is music. The way you speak is music. The way you move is music. My communication with most people is through music. I teach music. When you watch a movie, you have feelings not because of the movie, but because of the music. So I think music in general is more part of most people's life than they might even realize. But yes, it's a very big part of my life.
We're talking about a competitive world. If you want to be a pro, if you want to...
You know, I always think of competition that I'm only competitive with myself. Mm-hmm. And what I'm doing is different than what she's doing and then what that person's doing and what that person's doing. We all have a special gift, and if we think of it that way, it doesn't have to be competitive.
Bravo! Quin talent!
Good.
És normal que sentin que la flauta és una extensió del seu cos. Passen més hores enganxades a la flauta que soles. Segur que fins i tot hi dormen abraçades.
Yes, perfect, thank you.
És evident que l'Andrea i la Nicole són unes flautistes top. La Messi i la Ronaldo de les flautes, per entendre'ns. Però segur que no cobren tants calés.
A toast for you. Salut. Thank you.
L'André i la Nicole m'acaben de fer un regal meravellós. Encara estic impressionat. Quina sort que he tingut de conèixer la Nicole. I tot gràcies a l'Andrea. Qui m'havia de dir que Iowa amagava tant de talent?
Som el foc d'ahir a la nit, les brases del matí.
Okay, so let me show you my mansion.
Well... Quina passada. Wow. What a wonderful house. My God.
Well, this is only one room.
How many rooms do you have?
I'm not even sure. It's
probably
just
big. 15.
15?
15? I per ella sola?
Are you living alone?
Yes.
15 rooms for you?
Yes, okay. I one room a day.
Okay.
Que no cobren tants calés, potser m'he precipitat. Quina casassa. Oh,
this is a nicer hat. See, we're from cities. Like, I never had anything like this.
Ja us dic ara que m'he equivocat d'ofici. Em posaré a narrar concerts de flauta travessera, que veig que això dona molts calés.
Roman.
Crazy.
Com diria la meva àvia, aquesta casa té massa racons i és molt difícil d'escombrar. El que fa l'enveja, eh?
Impressionant. Another bathroom, another room. Okay, empty rooms.
En comptes d'una casa, sembla que m'hagi perdut a l'IKEA.
That's it?
No.
No?
There's a lot more.
Més, yeah. més, hi ha més. Som-hi.
Oh. Però que ho heu vist, això?
My God.
So, would you like to sleep in here? It's not working, so we can't have a pool party right now.
A pool party?
Yeah, a pool party. Atenció,
que hi ha sorpresa, eh?
Ai, ai, quins nervis.
No!
No! Una pista de bàsquet!
No! És el paradís! I want this house!
Déu meu, senyor, però vosaltres veieu el mateix que jo?
No m'ho puc creure! Jo vull viure aquí!
Li canvio tots els cèrvols del món per aquesta pista de bàsquet. Poc després, l'Andrea m'ha aclarit la situació. Ara flipareu. Paga exactament el mateix pel lloguer d'aquesta supercasa que pel seu apartament de Nova York. Quina bogeria! Després de posar-nos còmodes, l'Andrea m'ha volgut ensenyar les fundes que dissenya i amb què també es guanya la vida. Ah, i també m'ha confessat que té una gelateria a Manhattan. Aquesta noia és una crack.
I'm so relaxed now, here. Oh.
Yeah, no, I know, the fire. It's the fire.
Oh, a deer, no, it's okay.
I looked, why did I look? I wish, you couldn't even see them. If I had outside lights, I put food out for them.
But the first night she moved into this house,
I
was leaving, and I turned on my car lights and going out of the driveway, And just as I turn on the car lights, I see about 7 pairs of eyes looking at me, and there they were,
the deer. A whole family.
Really?
Sitting right across the driveway, just sitting there, waiting
for me. They knew I was coming. No, I seriously, they knew I was coming. They haven't been there since. They were welcoming me.
Really?
Yeah. No, absolutely. Absolutely. A buck, a doe, and 2 other fawns.
They represent something special for you?
Their spirit, gentleness and gracefulness and power.
Okay.
And even the mysterious, they disappear, and the lightness, they're so light and they just leap. Mm-hmm. If I were like blind and the doctor said, you could choose one thing to see, what would it be? And I would say, deer leaping.
Deer jumping. Okay.
Now you might think I'm a little nuts.
No.
Maybe we should stop.
Not at all.
I'm going too far. Let's go back to the flute bag.
Good night.
See you tomorrow.
Sleep well. I hope you see some deer.
Okay. Good night. Thank you.
Marxo a dormir al·lucinat per tot el que he viscut avui. Quan la vaig conèixer a la caravana, vaig pensar que l'Andrea tenia alguna cosa especial. Resulta curiós que algú com ella estigui tan obsessionada amb els cérvols. Ja se sap que els artistes tenen una sensibilitat especial, però per més que m'expliqui aquesta connexió que sent amb ells, no l'acabo d'entendre. Suposo que per això ella és una gran flautista i jo un gran sapastre. I per cert, de cérvols ni rastre. No deuen tenir ganes de veure'm. Jo amb ells tampoc. Bon dia, Iowa! La Nicole ens ha vingut a buscar a primera hora del matí. Ella i l'Andrea han planejat un dia que promet ser emocionant.
It's a nice morning.
Yes.
I hope to see some deer.
Però abans, fem un tomb pels voltants de la casa per veure si tenim sort i algun cèrvol vol passar a dir-me hola.
You have a lot of neighbors.
Well, yeah, okay. But I don't know them.
No, yeah. In Barcelona, you can live in the same building with a person a few years, mm-hmm. and you don't know.
You don't know who they are. Yeah.
Anybody. Same. Sometimes in the elevator, hi, and that's it.
I really am curious who those people are.
Yeah.
Like I want to meet them.
Yes.
They must be cool.
Some bright morning when this life is over.
Ja al cotxe i sense cèrvols a la vista, m'expliquen que anem cap a Whistlestop Farm, la granja de la seva amiga Ellen. Volen que la conegui perquè és una persona molt especial per elles. De moment, a Iowa són hectàrees i hectàrees de camps de blat de moro i prats plens de vaques. Aquí hi ha una casa cada 3 o 4 quilòmetres. Se'm plantegen 2 preguntes. Com s'ho fan aquí quan necessiten sal o una mica d'arròs? I, sobretot, què hi fan 2 flautistes top com l'André i la Nicole en un lloc com aquest?
We're going to meet my friend Ellen, and she teaches dressage, which is like horse jumping. She also plays the flute. She's a friend, but also a student of mine.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. So she lives here. Her house is attached to her horse arena.
Així que cavalls, eh? D'acord, a veure si amb els cavalls m'hi entenc més que amb els gats i els gossos.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
I'm Paul from Barcelona.
Hello.
Hello. Good to,
and welcome. She speaks a little bit of Spanish.
Yeah, sí? Poquito, sí.
Okay.
Hello. Good to see you. Hey, fluter.
Hey, hello.
Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Yes, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Wow. Do you play piano?
No, I don't. I play flute, like these two.
Okay.
But my friend who will be coming, he plays piano. He's a cowboy and a pianist.
Cowboy and pianist?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, good combination. Yeah. Interesting.
Com? Coneixeré un cowboy? Quina emoció. No paro de conèixer gent en aquest viatge.
What do you teach?
I teach, do you know dressage and driving? Dressage is an Olympics, one of the Olympic sports.
Yes.
I did that for 40 years. I competed internationally And now I teach people who are working to go to that goal. I'm a little old to compete at this point.
I com us veu conèixer?
Ellen played the flute when she was younger in school and didn't play for many years, like 35 years, I think, right?
Yeah, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I was doing the horses.
Yeah. You know. And I was teaching a summer program at the university, and Ellen came to that class, and she marched up to me and said, "I want a lesson." And I thought, well,
I don't think I said it, Gary, but maybe.
I want a lesson. Like that?
She was very enthusiastic. And I said, okay, there's something about her I really like, so I decided, sure.
I thought it was my Prada bag.
Well,
really
she had a Prada bag. I like that, too. Very fashionable. So we met for a lesson, and we sort of became instant friends.
Mm-hmm. For me, it's very interesting. People from my country, when they think about Iowa, they are thinking about the conservative farmer,
right.
The man with the gun, the, right. The hunter.
Well,
with...
he's coming. Okay. Yeah, okay. He'll be here soon.
Okay. So, okay. But in yeah. Iowa, we can find you, for example, a yeah. liberal woman.
That's right.
Who could travel around the world.
That's right. Sitting right here, right now, I am the alien. I am the Democratic alien in this square mile.
And yes. You can find them that they're friends.
Yeah, because Matt, who's coming, is my best friend. He's the heir to my farm. I have no close family, so mm-hmm. he's going to inherit this farm, and he's taken care of me and the farm, and he will get this farm when I die. And he's my best friend, and he's he doesn't believe in evolution, ultra conservative Christian, right, Trump supporter. And the kindest person you'd ever know, but I think he's nuts. But
yay, Matt's here.
Matt's here.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Howdy. How you doing?
Good.
Good to see ya.
See you too.
Hello.
Good day.
I'm Paul from Barcelona.
Paul. Nice to meet you. Dear.
How are you?
Matt.
Okay.
Mamas!
L'Ellen viu sola en aquesta granja des de fa molts anys. Bé, viu acompanyada dels seus cavalls. Amb ells, l'Ellen ha estat campiona en un munt de competicions per tot el món. Me la imagino com en aquella pel·li, la dona que xiu-xiuejava els cavalls.
No, no, aquí, 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 aquí. Molt bonic. Bé, Romeo, bé. Jo Maria Pou, criador de cavalls.
Val, i ara què faig amb la mà?
Què, està bo? Està bo? M'he encantat.
His bridle. So just stand there like that, he'll be fine.
Quina pressió, no?
Em mira. M'està mirant.
Hola.
I ara toca fer una volteta per la pista. Trobo que aquests animals m'agraden més que els que havia conegut fins ara. Yee-haw! Avui, a cases d'algú, passejant Miss Pou. Després de la passejada, mentre fem el dinar, no puc deixar d'observar en Matt. Mireu, mireu, un tros de cowboy de cap a peus. I quin tros de civella. Oh, quina barba. Té cabells per tot arreu. I quines mans! Com em recorda el noi de Brokeback Mountain. Pou, concentra't.
Yeah, Matt is Native American.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Cherokee and Passamaquoddy.
Cherokee? Oh. Mm-hmm. Wow. Mm-hmm. Interesting.
His ancestors
so
took scalps.
So you are a pure American.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's,
the rest of us all should go home, he thinks.
Do you think that you are more American than, I don't know, an Italian or a Syrian man who is here and have the citizenship?
No, because he's also got some German in him.
I don't think that way. But you're either American or you're not. I mean, there is no in between. What aggravates me, if you will, would be when somebody says, I'm an Italian-American, or I'm an African-American, or I'm a... What? I'm an American. It doesn't matter what the tribe was, whether it's Cherokee or Passamaquoddy or Italian or what. You're American. That's it.
But we have a problem with identity, I think. What are you? Are you American? Are you from... Are you Muslim? Are you Catholic? We have to put people in boxes.
Categories.
And if someone don't fit perfectly in a box, you have a problem.
Right. Mm-hmm. And of course, right now here, the biggest, there's two boxes, Republican and Democrat. And somehow we have to get through that and talk across that aisle, you know. And Matt, here's another one of those things where Matt and I are totally opposite. He's a gun dealer. I'm for gun control. So,
I'm for gun control, too.
Well, that's good to hear.
100%. No. That's why I deal.
Yeah. I don't believe in taking all the guns away, but nobody needs AK-47s or whatever they are using.
Matt, Helen told me before that you are a minister.
Okay. Yeah.
Can you explain me a little bit that? What kind of minister? What do?
Convert everybody.
Yeah, you can't convert anybody. That's not an act that a person can do. That's impossible. But you can bear witness to the truth, that you can do.
It's amazing that he and I are friends, isn't it?
A pure miracle.
So, do you believe that we are all created by a God?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. What do you believe?
I don't believe in God as well.
At all?
No. No, no. Yeah, I think we are coming from, well, monkeys or whatever you want, you know.
And they wouldn't exist anymore. That doesn't make any sense.
Who wouldn't exist? Monkeys?
Apes.
Oh.
Do you believe in God, Helen?
No.
No.
Definitively not.
Okay. Perhaps it's easier to live if you believe in God.
I think it probably is. It makes some things make sense. But on the other hand, things that happen like Rwanda, you know, or the people dying in Puerto Rico makes no sense to me if there's a God that's loving. So I would not want to believe in a God that allows those things to happen, for one thing.
What do you think about that, Matt?
I es va fer el silenci. En Matt no va voler respondre a la pregunta. Suposo que, en el fons, ell també és conscient que l'Ellen té part de raó i és difícil justificar-ho.
Oh, show him your phone. I told him about your phone.
She said nothing escapes, and so, of course, naturally, I...
What's that?
What is that? That's a phone.
It's not broken.
You open it, you hang up on people.
It's a prehistoric cell phone.
Matt does not believe in evolution, as you can tell.
Oh, okay. Not Twitter, not Instagram, not Facebook at all.
None of that.
Only messages and calls.
Calls.
Oh, calls. No messages.
Well, they come in message. Because I have to, with business and stuff, I get texts all the time.
I ain't gonna text. That's stupid.
Yeah, I agree with that, but I get texts all the time about you got to get this, or here's your material list, or this is what's going on.
You know, you obviously know what a bell curve is, and, you know, a bell curve.
Yes.
There has to be one on one end and one on the other. Hi, Matt.
That's why I say it's a miracle for us, literally. Her and I are total, total, like, way opposites on everything.
Yeah. Why you can be so close friends?
Supposed to get along with everybody. Isn't that what it says? I'm gonna hate my enemies. I thought it said love your enemies, do good those who. Isn't that what it says?
So you're the enemy on.
So you, she's the enemy.
Well, however you want to portray it, but you're supposed to get along with everybody, aren't you?
I think that you share values, but you don't share the origin.
Exactly.
Of the,
right. Exactly.
The reason of these values.
Exactly. Right?
Let's make a toast for that.
Yeah.
I don't have any more coffee, but I'll make a toast.
Yeah. I like so much this kind of conversation. Yeah.
And we share music.
Right. Yes.
Music is a universal language.
See, now that's the universal language with God again. Uh-huh. I mean,
so go play some now. So, now, then, now go
so,
play.
Yeah. No, no, let's celebrate this reunion with music.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
La música uneix, sí senyor. I és capaç de superar les diferències que semblen insuperables. M'encanta la relació que tenen l'Helen i el Matt. Com bé diu ell, podrien ser enemics, però al final la relació que tenen és totalment sincera i sana. El Matt serà l'hereu de l'Helen molt més enllà de la granja. Malgrat la distància ideològica, heretarà maneres de fer i de mirar la vida de la seva amiga. L'Andrea, la Nicole, l'Helen i en Matt. Quina família triada més meravellosa. No se m'acut millor manera de sobreviure a la soledat que amb aquesta companyia. Jo marxo d'aquí feliç i satisfet. No he vist cap cèrvol, però he tingut l'honor de conèixer un autèntic cowboy. Yeehaw! I torno a la caravana a descobrir noves històries. A tots els hi he fet les mateixes tres preguntes. Com et dius? D'on ets? I per què hauria de visitar el teu país?
My name is Rolf Erik.
Mengele.
Aaron.
Latifa.
Brisa.
D'on ets?
It's complicated. We are from Canada.
Eu sou do Brasil.
I'm from Bergen in Norway.
I'm from Italy, but my origin from Morocco and I live in Paris for 5 years.
Los tatuajes tienen una historia, todos?
Quando toda vez que eu faço uma viagem, na volta eu faço uma tatuagem do lugar que eu visitei. É, eu tenho o símbolo da Astra, também quando eu fui para Berlim.
Sí.
É, Nova York eu fiz essa daqui.
Se n'haurà fet algun de Barcelona? Per què hauria de venir a visitar la teva ciutat?
First of all, it rains a lot, so if you're familiar with rain, if you don't want to experience the good things about water and rain, it's perfect.
Ui, 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 no ho veig clar.
Toronto is a multicultural country. There's a lot of people from different countries.
I could take you sea kayaking on the very edge of the, well, the Norwegian continent, out in the open ocean.
Really?
So if you haven't tried it, I highly recommend it.
M'agrada.
São Paulo tem um clima confuso.
I think Italian food is the better.
And, of course, listening to my awesome rock band.
Ah, això ja sona molt millor.
Em convidaríeu a casa vostra?
Yes, sure. Yes, sure.
Really?
Yeah. Canada is inviting you. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. You seem like a nice guy, so yeah. Yeah.
Yes. Sim. Sim.
Hope to see you there.
I arribo a Bergen, a la costa de Noruega, per conèixer una mica millor el Rolf, un roquer que passa dels 40 i amb els braços plens de tatuatges. De moment, Bergen em sembla un lloc força tranquil. El Rolf em va dir que era la ciutat més plujosa de Noruega, però estic de sort i avui no plou. Potser només plou quan toquen ells. Li faria aquesta broma si no fos perquè em fa una mica de por amb tants tatus. Em pregunto com deu ser casa seva. Com a bon roquer, segur que la té desendreçada, no gaire neta i plena de restes de menjar i ampolles de cervesa de l'últim concert. Potser fins i tot m'hi trobo alguna fan dormint la mona al sofà del menjador. Encara no sé si a Bergen m'hi espera un cap de setmana d'esports i aventura o dos dies de sexe, drogues i rock and roll.
Hello!
Hey, welcome, welcome.
How are you?
Hey, good. Good to see you.
How are you?
Come in.
Thank you. Wow.
I tried to clean for you.
Doncs es nota, perquè està tot netíssim.
I like this piano.
Yeah, it's not...
És preciós, no?
This is the downstairs area. And,
Oh, Rolf, I like it.
El Rolf m'explica que treballa en un despatx, gestionant pisos de protecció oficial. No és la professió que m'esperava d'un roquer com ell. Em penso que el Rolf escapa a tots els clixés que m'havia imaginat. M'agrada. Això sí, és evident que la música té un lloc molt, molt destacat a la seva vida. I als seus prestatges.
So this will be your room for the night.
Okay.
But this is where my daughter lives.
Ah, okay, okay.
But she's not here. She's 10.
10 years old?
10 years old,
yeah. Okay.
But she's with her mom now, so.
Ah, okay.
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 So yeah, this...
Who are they? Singers or...?
Yeah, they try to be.
not your style at all.
No, not at all. They're 14.
I'm gonna be perfect, thank you very much.
A part de la música, a la vida del Rolf hi ha un altre gran protagonista. La seva filla de 10 anys.
Oh, you have artists in the family.
Yeah, it runs in the family.
Un roquer que prepara l'esmorzar de la seva filla i l'ajuda a fer els deures.
Actually quite good, as you can see.
Yes, absolutely.
Very talented girl.
Yes, yes.
El Rolf no para de sorprendre'm.
So you enjoy Norway?
Yes, yes. I don't enjoy the weather, but people and cities are okay. But the weather for me is a nightmare.
It is terrible. It's 250 days a year it rains.
250 days?
Yeah, it can. Yeah.
250 dies l'any plovent. But what's that? It's crazy.
Yeah, but we're used to it, though.
Yeah?
So, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, we can't complain about it. We can't do anything. So we can't move to Barcelona. It would be nice. You know, I have a meeting now.
Yes?
Yeah, with my band.
With your band?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Because playing this awesome rock band.
Wow, rock and roll time?
Yeah. So if you want to join, if you...
Perfect, I like it. I want to.
Yeah, you like rock and roll?
A lot. Yes. And do you play guitar?
Yeah, try to do my best. And we know that we're not going to be rock and roll stars since we're not that young anymore. Got families and... But it's fun.
I like this.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. Have a beer if you like. And it's fun. Yeah. It's right down the street, actually, so it's not far.
Let's go. Yes.
Yeah, you can go now. Perfect. Wanna finish your coffee?
Yes.
Per fi podré veure el Rolf i el seu grup en acció. I això que estiguin al final del carrer m'encanta. Oh, yeah! El Rolf m'explica que assaja un cop per setmana amb el grup i que intenten no fallar mai. Tenen un local d'assaig on es troben cada dijous al vespre. Una cita setmanal amb el rock. Espero que se saludin dient allò de «Bona nit, malparits!». Bé, seria més aviat «Gotna Darlik!» o alguna cosa així. Mentre parlem, vaig aprenent moltes coses dels costums noruecs. I una és que l'expressió «al final del carrer» no té el mateix significat que a casa nostra. Arribem al local d'assaig i em sorprèn que tot estigui tan net i endreçat. Tots els grups de rock nòrdic són així o només els que passen dels 40? El Rolf em presenta la seva banda. Es fan dir What Came From The Sea, que vol dir allò que va venir del mar. M'expliquen que tots componen cançons, que ja han tret un àlbum digital i dos vinils i que han fet diverses gires. M'ho expliquen amb tanta il·lusió que sembla que tinguin 20 anys. Ara tinc les expectatives molt altes. A veure com sona aquesta colla. En Rolf i els seus amics toquen amb una passió que m'ha deixat bocabadat. Ha estat agafar els instruments i transformar-se en veritables estrelles del rock. Almenys en l'actitud. Es nota que gaudeixen i que entre ells hi ha molt bon rotllo.
Bravo!
Després de l'assaig, tornem a casa del Rolf per sopar tots junts. Veurem si el bon rotllo que es respirava al local d'assaig continua en el món real. Ep, on són les pizzas congelades? No m'ho puc creure. El Rolf ha preparat un plat tradicional noruec. Sembla que aquest sopar roquer també se sortirà dels tòpics. No li ha vist la cara, o no? De moment, en Rolf no és gens com me l'imaginava. És millor. Aquell roquer ple de tatuatges resulta que és un home atent i molt bon cuiner.
I saw this Maradona picture in your rehearsal place. Why do you have a Maradona picture there?
Why is it? He is the best football player. And, well, he wrote a song about him. Took us to Argentina. That's why I wanted him to join the band, because he wrote that song. So I want to go to Argentina.
Cynical fuck, right? Anyway, so we got this idea to write this song about Maradona. Because obviously he, like he says, he's the best football player. He also embodies the rock and roll. He's rock and roll. You know, like Lionel Messi, fantastic player.
He's not rock and roll.
But he's not rock and roll. He's more like, you know, he's more like Toto.
Celine Dion.
Yeah, he's not Led Zeppelin. He's not Stones. Uh-huh. He's not a Mick Jagger kind of type.
Yes, I understand.
He's more like Enzo Ramazzotti. Is that
Eros,
he's Italian?
Eros Ramazzotti.
He's Italian.
No, I remember this conversation with a taxi driver in Napoli. Okay, and he asked me, who is the best, Maradona and Messi? And I answered to him, of course, Messi. And he stops the taxi. No, and he said to me, are you on drugs? Are you on drugs? And I answered to him, not me, Maradona.
Well, it took us to Argentina.
The song?
Yeah. So thank you.
How did you meet each other?
Gottfried is actually my father.
So he's the oldest person in the world.
This guy is...
Yeah. Me and Øystein used to be in another band. And then the drummer left, the drummer slash vocalist, we had a project going. And I knew that Torgeir was playing the drums. So I called him and said, hey, do you sing? I didn't know he was singing. So yeah, and then we started and we needed to find a drummer. Øystein came up with a brilliant idea and said, well, why don't we get Rune, which is the best drummer in all of Bergen. He doesn't like me saying that, but he is, don't worry.
So what do you do for a living?
I'm an appraiser at an insurance company.
Uh-huh.
And appraise buildings and...
I work in a warehouse selling tiles.
Mm-hmm. And what about you?
I'm a teacher.
Teacher?
Yeah.
He's the prima donna of the band. Because he's the singer, you know.
Oh, okay.
So we call him Natalie.
What?
Natalie.
Natalie?
Yes.
Why?
Because I'm weak.
And?
I need to sleep, you know. I need to sleep. I need to, you know, rest my, you know, my throat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I need to sleep.
Yeah. Like a star, you're a star.
And me and him kind of go the other way.
Especially him. You know, he's a machine.
Is he a machine?
He's a machine.
What kind of machine?
He never stops.
Okay. Yeah. I believe him.
You believe me?
I think that you are you have this energy all the time. No?
He can drink. You know, he can drink for... How long are you going to be here?
2 days.
2 days. Mm-hmm. He can drink for 2 days.
He's afraid of silence.
Really?
He doesn't like silence. He doesn't believe in the power of silence. you should introduce him to the heaven.
I mean, come on.
Underberger.
What's that? Is that
that's fuel.
Is that legal or?
You know, don't ask.
Underberg. Do you like that? Yes.
Yeah.
Very much.
It's medicine.
Enjoy.
Ah, és dolent com una mala cosa. Ah.
Blame the Germans.
What's that?
That's a new Natalie. You're even weaker than me.
I'm the real Natalie.
Si continuo bevent així, encara em despertaré demà sense saber on sóc i amb un tatuatge amb el nom de la banda tota l'esquena.
We rehearse once a week, every Thursday from 7. It's band time kind of thing. And it's been like that for years. It's quite funny. We just know that we're going to show up and everything is okay.
I liked so much this kind of commitment. It's a hobby, but it's friendship.
It's like a sanctuary where you can be who you are and be, you know, whatever
you want to be.
Be whatever you want to be. Yes. You know? Yeah, I've got 2 children and family. And that's beautiful, but it's also beautiful to hang out with these guys, even him.
So guys, can we do a final toast?
Sure.
Because Natalie is tired.
Yeah.
I want to go.
Natalie has a long day tomorrow.
I'm tired.
Durant el sopar, m'he sentit entre amics. Es nota que entre tots quatre hi ha una connexió especial. Això de tocar junts cada setmana i de fer bolos ha d'unir per força. Per ells, el grup és l'oportunitat per deixar de ser oficinistes, mestres, venedors d'assegurances i treballadors de la construcció i ser allò que sempre han somiat. Amb els amics poden ser estrelles del rock.
Salut. Thank you very much for this dinner.
Thank you. Ah. Medicina.
Hora de dormir. Espero no trencar el llit a la filla del Rolf.
Enjoy the dinner and
very, very well. Thank you very much.
Okay. Good night.
See you tomorrow. Good night. Bye. See you.
Me'n vaig a dormir pensant que demà coneixeré el Rolf, aventurer i esportista. I potser descobriré si jo també ho sóc. Demà toca estrenar-se amb el caiac. No ho veig gens clar. Espero que almenys no plogui. O sí, que plogui molt i s'anul·li l'excursió. Sisplau, sisplau. Bon dia, Bergen! Visca, està plovent! Perdó. Oh, està plovent, quina mala sort. Estic d'enhorabona i m'ha tocat un dels 250 dies que sí que plou. Ara li diré al Rolf que busqui una altra activitat per avui. Conèixer la biblioteca de la ciutat, anar a fer la compra o mirar el teletienda local.
Good morning!
Hey, good morning! You up?
How are you?
Hey, you had a good night of sleep?
Yes, thank you very much.
You want coffee? Here you go, sir.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy.
It's raining.
But either way, we're going to stay in the water, so...
What?
We're going to stay in the water anyway, because we're going to paddle.
Oh, some kayaks. Yes, really?
So...
Com? Que hi vol anar plovent? Ara és quan surt el boig roquer. Jo que havia baixat amb el pijama per fer-li pena? First time. Doncs no ha funcionat.
It's difficult to do?
Very.
It's very difficult.
You'll be all right, you'll be all right.
Tinc la sensació que quan estem sols, al Rolf li costa més deixar-se anar. Quan està envoltat de gent, surt el Rolf més sociable, i quan està sol, es torna a tancar. Tenir un desconegut a casa que et fa preguntes impertinents no deu ser gens fàcil. També l'entenc. A mi em passaria una cosa molt similar. aprofitaré que estarem tancats dins del cotxe i que no es podrà escapar per preguntar-li un munt de coses. Soc malèfic. I grab you by your ear till
the cracks on your lips appear. I guess there are... How often do you see your daughter?
I have her 50% of the time, so I have her one week at a time. Uh-huh. So this week she's with her mom. There's pros and cons. I can't say when she's with me all the time, so I can't. I can go to rehearsal once a week, but I can't go paddling. I can't, because I want to be with her. But then again, she enjoys paddling and she's been with me.
Yes?
Yeah. That's why I bought two kayaks in the beginning, because, well, first of all, it's easier to have a friend come out with you. And also, we have a cabin by the sea, and I wanted to be able to go with her.
Is your only daughter?
I have two daughters.
Two daughters?
Yeah. I have... I want living in Denmark with her mom.
But how hard is it is to have a daughter living in another country? And
well, it's... I mean, the distance from here to Copenhagen. She doesn't live... She lives outside Copenhagen in another city. But from here to Copenhagen, it's just 1 hour.
Okay.
But it's hard. But it's been like that since she was born, basically. She stayed here. We stayed together for half a year. Wow. And then she moved back to Denmark.
Okay.
El Rolf veu poc les seves filles i quan en parla es nota que les troba a faltar. M'ha sorprès com li canvia l'expressió de la cara quan parla d'elles. You gotta hold on. You gotta hold on. Parem a buscar els vestits per anar en caiac. El Rolf em promet que amb això no em mullaré gens ni mica. Vols dir?
Hello.
Are you okay?
Per què no s'ha inventat el caiac indoor?
Thank you.
On sou quan us necessitem, inventors?
Are you ready? How do you say?
Ai, mare, ai, mare, que ha arribat el moment. Aquest paio no es fa enrere. I aquesta aigua deu estar gelada. Patirem, Pou, patirem.
Ok. Don't leave me alone, please.
Diuen que l'aigua freda va bé per la circulació. Si caic, circularé cagant llets. Som els dos únics sonats capaços de posar-nos a l'aigua en aquest dia. Però començo a sospitar que valdrà molt la pena. Quina meravella. Gràcies, Rolf. I després d'aquest meravellós passeig, tornem a port. Ho has aconseguit, Pou! Ha estat una de les experiències més al·lucinants de la meva vida. Això, o que per culpa del fred la sang no m'ha arribat al cap. En qualsevol cas, estic encantat. El Rolf surt a navegar dos cops per setmana. Per ell, estar sol amb el caiac enmig de l'oceà és un repte mental. Així és el Rolf, algú que s'enfronta al perill i que no renuncia a allò que realment vol fer perquè està convençut que al final, corre el risc, valdrà la pena. Trobo que he de sortir més sovint de la meva zona de confort.
Great experience.
You did good.
Are you hungry now?
Yeah.
Me too.
There's room in here for some. Let's go far today and it's all gonna be fine. Sweet.
Do you like the loneliness of this activity or do you prefer to share these experiences?
The loneliness is a good thing. I mean, sharing it with people. I mean, like when I told you earlier that we paddle up in the north. I mean, I was supposed to go alone and go there and, you know, say, oh, look at this, look at this. Oh, it's so beautiful. You need someone to share it with.
Do you like to spend a lot of time with your daughter?
Yeah, she's super funny. I mean, so she's 10 years old. She's got all these funny questions. So you never get bored because she's...
I don't have sons, I don't have daughters. How do you know if you are a good dad?
I don't know. Maybe try spend time with them and fulfill their needs, of course, and be there for them when they need you. And as long as you enjoy spending time with them, I think that is a good thing.
Do you ask yourself this question sometimes or not?
I haven't asked myself if I'm a good dad or not. I think I am, except that we got divorced, me and her mom. I think one should stay together. But maybe the alternative's not always the best, so... She says I'm a good dad.
Yes.
Okay. And I spent time with her. I've been fortunate enough to be around her all her life. And when she was in kindergarten, I was educating myself at home. Okay. So got to spend a lot of time with her. So she went to kindergarten like late in the morning, and, okay, or in the, and came home early. So we got to spend a lot of time together, which I think now is very important that we had. So I'm glad.
And what about the other one? The older one is. It's difficult, no? Because she's living in Denmark.
Yeah, she lives in Denmark. It's hard because I want to see her more. But things are what they are, and I just have to make the best of it because my kids are the most important. Mm-hmm. They're mini-me's. I mean, they're very important to me.
Okay, of course. So, thank you very much for having me.
Thank
you very much for sharing this time with me.
Really hope you enjoyed it.
I enjoy it so much.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much. If you don't mind, I want to share with you beer.
Yeah.
Yes. I don't have.
I think I'll manage.
Really?
Els meus dies amb en Rolf s'acaben. M'adono que he viatjat amb la idea de conèixer un roquer amb síndrome de Peter Pan i m'he trobat amb algú molt diferent. He conegut un home madur que s'ho passa bé fent rock and roll i navegant, però que té molt clar que el més important de la seva vida són les seves filles. El Rolf, tot i que viu sol, és un home de família. Una mica com l'Andrea, una dona talentosa que viu sola en una casa enorme, però que també té una família. En aquest cas, una família triada. La Nicole, l'Helen i el Matt. Ah, i els cèrvols, esclar. Em farem fum, a casa meva és casa vostra, si és que hi ha casa... Per cert, a Noruega hi ha cèrvols o què? Potser encara en veuré algun.